long throw in this tight end role. I know you guys used him quite a bit last year, but it seems like he's kind of taken it to a different level.
Yeah, I think he's grown in his role and really both aspects of the game in the run. You know, as we see the the passing stats and his you know, as he's had some touchdowns over the past few weeks, but there's also been a obviously an increased role in him with the run game, and obviously he's done that at a good level for us as well.
He seems like he's kind of a very upbeat person, kind of takes the sort of thing like a position switch in stride.
Yeah, I think he has a ton of energy out of practice, always happy, always smiling, wanting to be coached, wanting to get better, and so I think he's been, he's, for a guy like, for Dan Rochard, he's great to have in the room and great for, the teammates, but he's been a pleasure to coach.
Pete, when you utilize Taysom Hill to the extent that he was utilized in this past week, how does that impact a defense, even when he's not on the field, when Andy Dalton comes in and he's under center?
Yeah, I think that if you talk to defensive coaches about the time that they got to be spending, not only when Andy's on the field, but also the role that Taysom plays, and the nice thing last week is we were able to get into some sustained drives, get him on the field, get him off the field. But I think I've said this before, that we come out of games where he doesn't have enough plays, but we're always looking for opportunities to get him on the field.
Does it create more opportunities even when he's not on the field though? Like when you are able to get him mixed in?
Well, I think, they probably have a plan for when he is on the field or for when he's not on the field. They play their base defense probably for the most part of the game, but maybe there's certain exceptions to it when he's at the quarterback or he's in a certain role that they could adjust.
Dennis said that he didn't intentionally switch him literally on and off every single play. Did you know?
No, I don't think that – the plan was to get him as – when we're sustaining drives and going, we want him to be a big part of those drives, as well, as a lot of other guys. It wasn't planned to go 1-2, 1-2, 1-2 like that. It just kind of that's the way it came out. That's the way, the situations presented themselves. Maybe the down and distances where we felt, hey, let's get him on the field for a play here. So I think, I think that more than anything was really random. But the thought of having him on the field for as many plays as we can was part of the plan.
Taysom said that could have been basically any game. That's just kind of how the call sheet worked. Is that an accurate assessment?
I think when you go back to the previous two games where we didn't have a lot of plays, we didn't sustain drives, we just never really got into a rhythm of being able to do that. I think that throughout the whole season, no secret, we want him to be on the field. We want to try to get him. He's one of our most talented players. We love when he's out there. Something good we think is going to happen. So I guess just the way the flow of the game went, we were sustaining drives and able to get him out there.
I'm sorry to ask another one. I'm sure you're so sick explaining this every single week. But, why do you guys have to be sustaining drives for him to get him?
I don't necessarily. I mean, he might be in on first or second, but then all of a sudden you're in third and,
right,
a long situation, and you're calling something with Andy, a quarterback, and then the series is over. And so you just never get into that rhythm. I know what you're saying, but the last two games prior to that, we had 50 snaps, and almost 20 to 25 of those were 2 minute where we're at the line going. And so it's just being able to sustain drives and have opportunities to get him out there.
And then when he is getting 15, 20 snaps, does he have to be throwing the ball some just to kind of keep that effective and keep the defense maybe kind of?
Yeah, I think that's part of the game plan is that he's playing the quarterback position and able to do multiple roles. So I think that when he's at the quarterback position, is he running, throwing? I think that works to our advantage if you can keep the defense maybe guessing.
Looked like Rashid Shaheed got maybe a little bit more run than some of his other guys. What has he done to earn that?
I think he's proven to us that when he's been out there, he's been productive. Again, he's another guy that you can come off and say we'd love to get his more balls to, and I think that, we've been more exposed to him throughout practices, throughout the weeks, and having put him out there, we feel really good when he's on the field. And I think he's a player that we continue to see his role expanding.
Have your eyes been open to Juwan Johnson's, growth and kind of contributions this season? I know, obviously, looking back on the history of Saints tight ends, does Jimmy Graham or somebody kind of stand out as somebody you can compare Juwan to?
I think this, again, is, you know, we're still going through the season. We'll probably do all that evaluation at the end of the year and kind of see where he's at. But I think that just as he's grown in this offense, obviously there's a lot of confidence from us as a coaching staff, putting him on the field and letting him be the target. I think his role will continue to expand. And again, he's really accepted the challenge and gone out there and played well. Well, I still came away from we didn't have as many third down. We only had 9 going into the 2 last drives where we had a couple 4-minute third downs. But I thought that we were efficient on first and second down, giving ourselves to either not even get to third down or getting ourselves in a little bit more manageable positions. But I still think that, you know, from an overall perspective, we didn't have any turnovers last week, but we still have had some too many of those. And then, you know, I think over the last few games, our third down numbers haven't been as well. And so I think that's an area that we got to, you know, focus on.
Seems like the 49ers have a lot of defensive playmakers just about every level of that defense, but how important is Fred Warner to what they do?
Yeah, he's. You can see that he controls a lot of what they're doing, you know, with the calls and getting guys lined up. But it's obviously a very talented defense. But you just see him, he tackles so well. He's always in the right spot. I think just in general, when you look at the team, they're going to present a big challenge for us. They really make you have to, they don't give up many big shots down the field. They, you know, make you have to earn it. And then at some point, you know, teams are stalling their drives. And when I say that, they're going to make you earn it. But they also get off the field pretty quickly. And then they, you know, there's not a lot of snaps when you go to the whole season and look at them. They haven't had to defend a ton of red zone opportunities because they've kept teams from sustaining those drives.
And then with Andy, is like rhythm passing game a strength of his?
I think it's important to get into a rhythm early. But he played at the high level last week. I thought he made some really big time throws in that game, even some downfield throws where guys were covered. But I think that. You know, as you put the plans together, you know, every week it's all, you know, marrying your run with play action and you know, not being afraid to get into drop back with Andy and just drop back and throw it. So I think that he's done those things at a good level for us.
We've seen Alvin sort of get split out wide a little bit more toward the sort of half of this season. What kind of a stress does that put on a defense where you have a player that can do that?
Yeah, I think obviously he's a threat when the ball's in his hands. But he obviously has the ability for us. He's obviously been very successful running the football, but also very successful in when we've given him opportunities in the pass game. So obviously, if you would ask a defensive coach, I would assume that they would say that he's a guy that they got to know where he's at, where he's lining up, and you know, be paying attention to.
Might not be able to, but didn't see him out of practice today. Is there any update you're able to
give? Yeah, I'll let Dennis handle that or when the report comes out. Happy Thanksgiving. All right. Have a good day. All right.